Hi, I'm Dr. Minerva Santos, and welcome to Your Health Today, the medical show that keeps you looking good and feeling good from the inside out. My guest today is Marilyn Miller, who is the owner of Pilates on the Hudson, which is a Pilates studio in the Peekskill area. Pilates is not what you think it is. Pilates is not what they do in the gym. There's a lot of bastardizations, if you would use the words, of what Pilates is. Give us a little bit of history about Pilates and Joe Pilates, and set the record straight that it's not being in the gym, laying on your back, doing sit-ups.
Well, first, just to clarify, my business is Pilates on Hudson, not on Pilates Hudson. On the Hudson. Everyone confuses it. Pilates on Hudson. I am in Peekskill. I'm down in the Charles Point area. Pilates is actually a type of exercise that was originally created by Joseph Pilates, and he created this during World War I. He actually had been in London training the London Police Department in self-defense and physical fitness, and Joseph Pilates himself was originally from Germany. When World War I broke out, the Brits weren't too fond of having a German national right in the midst of their police department, so they very kindly asked him to go with them to the Isle of Man and put him in a prisoner of war camp for the next 4 years. So he was there, and of course they had no TVs and, you know, nothing to do or anything else, so he ended up being in the infirmary trying to help the soldiers that they were bringing in that had been injured in the war, the other prisoners. And World War I was the first war where they really used what we think of now as conventional warfare. I mean, they had poison gas and bombs and artillery and everything else. It was really the first big step up. So the injuries that they were seeing, they had never seen before. They had no idea what to do with it. And the doctors were like, I don't know, try this. They used to have, and you certainly as a doctor are familiar with this, they used to have traction beds.
Right.
So when they would do surgery on a person, if it was a really extensive surgery or whatever, they would just put the patient in traction. So, okay, we've repaired your arm and hang your arm up and we'll check back in 6 weeks. Hope you're good. And move on to the next person. So Joseph Pilates saw all of these guys, these very healthy men that had had these injuries and were now lying there with their arm or their leg or whatever else up. And he thought, well, you know, your body starts to atrophy in terms of its muscle tone within a week.
Right.
So if you're lying immobilized in a bed for 6 weeks, your whole body is going to have all of these problems. So he thought, well, maybe we can start exercising while you're still in the bed. So necessity being the mother of invention, he used bed springs because all they had were like, you know, mattresses on the old fashioned bed springs. So he used the bed springs, he used pulleys, he used ropes, just kind of whatever they had hanging around, and created this whole kind of machine out of the traction bed. And interestingly enough, a lot of people use the fitness circle. If you've done Pilates, if you do mat Pilates at the gym, a lot of times they'll have the ring that you work with. The ring actually first came from a small beer keg. So everything was utilized in some way. And he put together, he had a background in yoga and calisthenics and strength training and circus movements and boxing, and just he was very diverse in terms of what his knowledge base was. So he started working with these guys that were in these hospital beds and said, let's see if we take this spring and we attach it here and we put a strap on it and let's put your foot into it and maybe you can do some leg presses or some arm presses or something. And he started kind of blending these yoga, boxing, circus moves, everything else with the physical restrictions that were on the patients at the time. So he kind of, like, that's when the seed started germinating in his mind as to what he wanted to do. After the war, rather than going and joining Hitler and the SS and training the SS, he wisely decided he needed to come to New York. So he got on a boat, moved to New York, and got a studio on 56th Street. And he stayed there for, think his studio stayed there until the end of his life. In fact, I think it remained there after it. Yeah, I think it's part of a gymnasium or something else now, but I think it's still there. Anyway, once he got to New York, dancers came, and dancers started recognizing the benefits of this. Particularly,
that's why I thought he was a dancer.
Right, because he did a lot of work.
I think everybody thinks he's a dancer.
Yeah,
right.
He did a lot of work with dancers. He worked with Martha Graham. He worked with George Balanchine and both of their original companies. I just actually saw a flyer from Jacob's Pillow, which is the big dance festival up in Beckett, Massachusetts. And it has a whole picture and little article about how Joseph Pilates was very involved with the dance scene and the dancers up in Jacob's Pillow in the summers. Mm-hmm. So once he came and started working with the dancers, he started to really realize how broad the movements could then become, because the dancer started saying, oh, you know, let me do this big leg extension, and let me do this huge back bend and all this stuff. And it really became one of the most amazing rehab slash post-rehab exercise techniques that I think anyone has ever created. In terms of how I came into doing Pilates, I myself was a professional ballet dancer. And I started dancing when I was about 5 years old. By the time I was 13, I was already apprenticing with a local pre-professional company. And when I first saw Pilates, I was actually at the University of Utah's ballet department, and they had the Pilates Reformers. Now, it's interesting to me, this is going back over 20 years, possibly pushing 25 years, which is a little frightening. But it's going back, you know, at least two decades plus when I very first saw a reformer. And even at that time, that was in the mid 80s, Joseph Pilates had already passed away and had been dead for almost two decades when I first used it. So it is a technique that's been around for, at this point, almost 100 years. We're getting really close
to
100th anniversary.
Actually, when I was in NYU, because I was a dance major at NYU, it was very popular. NYU was down in the Village. It was very popular.
Right.
And this was in the 70s.
Right. So considering that you were in New York and in a dance program, that makes sense. But as you kind of go out into the world, for the longest time, you know, once I found it in the dance department at the University of Utah, there would be places, and as I traveled throughout my dance career, there would be places where it's like, oh yeah, you know, if you go, you know, kind of like, if you go down the back alley and make a right turn and go up the stairs and knock on the door three times, then there's the Pilates studio.
St. Joe sent you.
Yeah. But the general public had no knowledge that it was there. It was really kind of our little secret, and we kind of kept it that way. We're happy about that. When I moved to San Francisco and was dancing for a number of companies out there, including working as a soloist dancer for the San Francisco Opera, I was so fortunate that they actually had a whole center for dance medicine in San Francisco that was part of one of their main hospitals, at St. Francis Hospital. So they had incorporated Pilates fully into their rehabilitation program. So I'd go in, be seen by the orthopedist, who would be like, okay, this is totally, your knee is gone, your hip is gone, your shoulder, like your foot, everything, your whole body's gone. We would do physical therapy, and then we would go into Pilates. And why we would do that is, physical therapy really right now works with getting you out of the acute stage of any kind of an injury. Mm-hmm. So, and the way it's kind of set up is it deals with the specific point of injury. So if you've got a specific issue going on with your foot, okay, we're going to deal with your foot, and we're going to get, if it's plantar fasciitis or if you've got bunions or whatever else is going on, tendonitis, we're going to deal with that. And we're going to give you some general exercises to kind of work what might immediately be causing that issue. But it doesn't take this whole body approach.
Right.
And what Pilates does is it steps back a little bit more and says, okay, you've got a foot injury. If you're a dancer, you're going up, especially a ballet dancer, going up on your toes all the time. So there's a lot, when you look at what the kinetic chain of movement is in a dancer, there's a lot of stuff that goes all the way up the body. So it may be that that foot injury is resulting from something going on in your hip.
Mm-hmm.
And your hip injury may be resulting from something going on in your back. and your back may contributing to be something going on in your shoulder. So it's a whole body approach where once you get out of extreme pain from doing a physical